Welcome. In this tutorial, we'll be going over some of the basics of the reporting tab, which will be to create our own report from scratch. Due to the nature of this video, the whole segment will be a personal touch project. For our personal touch project, we'll be learning how to create a parking report. This will be a very simple report that will just kind of explain the foundation of how the report creation tool works. If this isn't what you're looking for, please check out our advanced reports tutorial. Let's start by selecting the new button. Let's start off with naming our report. I'll name this one Parking Time Report. Next, we'll select the type of report. In order for us to run report across multiple units, we'll need to select the unit group type report. Now that we have the base of the report set up, reports will have three different control points: contents, settings, and bindings. We'll only be going over some of the parts of contents and settings in this tutorial. If you plan to export your reports to print them or send them by email, I highly recommend starting off with the statistics page. This is a cover page for your report and gives you a summary of what the rest of the report will be about. By clicking on the statistics button, we can add the report name, the group of units being run on it, the starting interval for a report, the ending interval for the report, and the execution time of the report. Once we've added the data we wish to the front page, we'll click OK at the bottom. Now, let's add a new table. A report can hold many different tables, but in this case, we're only going to use one. Now, let's select the type of report or table we're going to have. I'll scroll down to Parkings. You can also edit the name of this table if you need to. Now we can select the columns that we want to go on our report. For my report, I want Beginning, which I'll rename to Parking Start by clicking on the name of the column. End, which I'll rename to Parking End. Duration, which I'll rename to Park Time. And location. But this isn't the order I want it to be in. I prefer location to be first. In order to rearrange this, I'll select the drag up, drag down icon and pull the location column to the top of the list. Now that we got our columns sorted, let's see how we want to format our rows in the table settings. Rows are formatted by creating groupings. I'll add two groupings, including unit and date. This will create two new rows in my report. Below groupings, I'll also select detailization. This will separate each parking into its own row. Lastly, I'll select row numbering. This creates a little more organization when reading down the table. Now, let's just make sure we have everything saved by pressing the OK button in the bottom right of each window. Now, let's go to the settings page next to the contents page. We're going to add a small bit here that we'll see later in the reading report tutorial. Expand the map output options and let's select parking meters and trip routes. To close this out and save properly, we'll hit OK in the bottom right corner again. Now we can verify our report template saved here in the reports template panel below. Congratulations and thank you for completing our tutorial on report creation. I hope by now you feel a little more at ease when operating through our platform. To further extend your knowledge of our platform, check out our other video tutorials. I'll see you next time!